Maybe you missed it because you were sleeping in, but our society loves an early riser. Do about 10 seconds of research online and you'll be bombarded by article after article linking success and productivity to getting up early. Even artistic inspiration hits early. Jay-Z woke up at 4:44 to write the title track to his new album. So while we're sleeping and being broke, he's making a number one album in the country. Go figure. But if you're not into the whole getting up early thing, well then you're kinda at a disadvantage. This is especially true if you're a teenager in school. In the US, over 80% of public schools start the day before 8:30 a.m. Many researchers believe that these early start times are a major reason why there's a serious sleep problem among students. One recent poll by the National Sleep Foundation found that almost 90% of high schoolers weren't getting the doctor recommended 8.5 hours of sleep a night. So what's happening? Why is getting up early for school so difficult for teenagers? If you've ever pulled an all-nighter and feel like a zombie the next day, then you know how important sleep is to functioning like a sane human being. Sleep doesn't just improve things like your memory, concentration, and your ability to have a coherent conversation. It's the body's main repair mechanism, doing things like healing your heart and blood vessels and maintaining the right balance of hormones. But getting enough sleep isn't always so easy. Maybe you've tried things like turning off your phone or computer like an hour before you go to sleep. But first, just one more episode of Game of Thrones. And then before you know it, it's 2 a.m., you're 4 hours into a serious binge-watching session. I mean, it's kinda your fault, but what time your body actually falls asleep might largely be out of your control. It's embedded in your genes. All mammals, including humans, have a tiny region in the brain called the suprachiasmatic nucleus. Yeah, sound that out. The suprachiasmatic nucleus, or the SCN. It's a bundle of around 20,000 neurons that contains what researchers call clock genes. The SCN is referred to as the body's master clock, telling the body when to go to sleep and when to wake up. Sleep researchers refer to your body's preferred sleep pattern as your chronotype, and there's quite a range of chronotypes. On one extreme, you've got the early birds, aka those people that are way too perky at 6 a.m., and on the other end, you've got the night owls, like that friend that calls you up at midnight to see if you want to go to that show featuring that band that you've never heard of and they're just in town for one night. Hello?
Dude, you gotta get over here. The flaming death slugs are opening for decaying rot mucus.
Dude, it's like midnight, man. I'm not coming outside for no flaming whoever's, man. I gotta go, bruh.
Yeah, that friend. Curious what your chronotype is, but don't have the time or money to submit your DNA for a genetic analysis? Not a problem. You can figure this out by measuring the midpoint of your sleep when you don't have to set an alarm to wake you up. If you naturally fall asleep at midnight and wake up at 8, then you have a chronotype of 4 a.m. Your chronotype isn't set in stone for life, though. It actually shifts as you age. The biggest change happens to teenagers. When puberty hits, the master clock experiences a phase shift. Chronotypes slowly get later and later, and by 18, the average chronotype is around 4:30 a.m. So getting enough sleep the night before an early class probably ain't gonna happen. Teenagers are wired to sleep in. Because of this research, organizations like the CDC, the American Medical Association, and the American Academy of Pediatrics all want school to start later than 8:30 a.m. In a 3-year study of over 9,000 students from different high schools across multiple states, the percentage of students sleeping at least 8 hours per night was twice as high in late start schools than in early start schools. Some studies have also shown that delayed start times are associated with better grades and improved test scores, but the evidence for that is inconsistent. Still, with some pretty solid evidence on the side of delaying school start times, why do 4 out of 5 public schools in the US start before 8:30 a.m.? One reason? Work. Parents have to get their kids to school before their workday starts at 9, and a later start time means school ends later, meaning even more disruption to daily schedules. Some teachers are against it too. In one county in Maryland, for example, 12,000 teachers voted almost 2-to-1 against any sort of delay, and 65% of them believe that shifting the school schedules would be too disruptive. But the biggest roadblock to starting school later might be sports. We take our school sports pretty seriously here in the US, which is fine, but I'm still trying to get more schools to adopt my favorite after-school activity, beekeeping. I mean, we gotta save the bees, people. No bees, no us. There's no us without bees. Anyway, in school board meetings, it's not uncommon for parents to say that delaying school start times will kill school sports by messing with game schedules. But there's really not any research to back up those claims. Now, are you catching on to the theme here? People just don't want to change the way they're doing things, even when science says that they probably should. So what do you think? Should school start later? Take this poll over here and let us know what schedule works best with your chronotype. And if you like this video, you should check out our video over here on how schools are trying to help homeless students. And please, please, if you like this video or anything we've done in the past, or just want to stay up to date with what we're doing and are gonna do, you should subscribe to our YouTube channel. Please and thank you. Till next time, guys. Peace out.